foundation of the world. Thank you. Thank you. Holy righteous God, Father, we come before you in Jesus' name, God, just to give you thanks once again, because you yet declared in your word that this is the day that the Lord has made. Oh God, let us rejoice and be glad in it. Oh Father, as we bring this family before you this day, Lord, actually, if you will, God, to comfort their very heart. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we know that you are able, God, to give them strength, Lord, because you say you will give strength unto your people. And you will bless your people with peace. Lord, strengthen them today under the sound of my voice. Oh, God, strengthen them one by one, name by name. Oh, God, as only you can, Father. You said in your word that you came to heal the broken heart. Heal that broken heart today. Under the sound of my voice, God. Oh, Father God, we ask you to bless the preacher man today as he stands before the peoples, Lord, to minister thine word, God. Oh, God, prick the very hearts of your people. Help us all to know that time is winding up and you're soon to come, God. Oh, God, help us to be ready, God, when you crack the sky. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Oh, God, bless every child, every son, every daughter, every brother, every sister. Bless them under the sound of my voice. Do it for your glory. We'll forever glorify, magnify, and praise your name. These and all blessings we ask in Jesus' name. Let every heart say, amen. Again, amen. One more time.
Amen.
Jerry used to say, "What a mean." When he say that for me. Those who have your Bibles, we got two passages of scripture. One at Psalms 91, and verse number 14. And the other one will be 2 Timothy 4. Listen to what the Bible says. He said, because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him, and I will set him on high. Why? Because he knows my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him, and I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Jerry had long life. He gave it to me. With long life, but I sanctify him and show him my salvation. Amen. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse number 6. Jerry probably was talking to the Lord, telling him, "But I am not ready to be offered. In the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord gives, the righteous judge shall give me at that time, and not to me only, but unto all of them that love his appearance." Amen.
Drive a truck. I went told that I talked to him.
He said, Bobby, if that's what you want to do, you had to try. I said, motherfucker, I don't know whether I want to do it or not. He said, try it anyhow. You might like it. So I went on and tried. And when the winter went down there to the piggy bank, I drove a truck with him for about a year and a half. And I told him, I said, motherfucker, I think I'm going to have to let it go now. I'm going to have to go back to home. He said, Bobby, if that's what you want to do, what I mean, man, that's what you got to do. And I said, Parker, I think that's what I'm going to do. But Mr. Parker, I'm going to miss you. I'm going to miss you, Mr. Parker. Because I know, Mr. Parker, you was a good man. You was a good man to me and everybody that you seen and everybody that you talked to day by day. Each one of the places that you always go by and talk, you always treated everybody right. You never treated no one wrong that I know of, Mr. Parker. So, Mr. Parker, I said, sleep on. So one day, brother, I will see you again.
To each of you respectively, I would say that that's my little one. We addressed that thing some years ago. I did something and he said, my. So then he started calling me the big brother and I called him the little brother. But only in stature that I'm larger than him, but in character, I will never exceed. Because Jerry was a person that gave and stopped giving. No doubt some of you here he gave too, I'm quite sure. And he gave me my first automobile. 6500, Galaxy 500. But I didn't just stop with that gift. I wanted to let him know that I appreciated it. So I invested in it. I put time in it. I painted it. I had it looking good. And when he see it, well, that thing looked pretty good. So I might want to take it back. I said, no, you gave it to me. But he was just kidding about that, and he bought a GTX Super Commander. Y'all know color, y'all know what I'm talking about. But I told him, I said, I'll swap now. He said, no, he said, too fast for you. But as I say, y'all, Jerry had to start an early adult life because he had his little brother to see about. And he started out farming, you know, making $1 a day. That was a lot of money back then, $1 a day. But he brought it home to our mother. You know, kids bring the money home to their mom now, but now, you know, we make kids got it now. Mom gets something she wants. But, I mean, but Jerry was, and as I say, and I didn't know at the time he was buying me the car, but he was getting ready to leave. But he wanted us to have a way to grow. So he gave me that vehicle. So I can't never repay it, you know? So what he done, I mean, sure, he had faults. Don't y'all? I don't think nobody's not is without faults. But just rest assured that was my little brother. But he proceeded now with his, which he never seen, his twin, Nehemiah. Jerry was a twin if you didn't know that. And I guess you know it now. But I called him, my mama, and his brother, the trio is together now. But I would like to thank each of you for coming, I know he would be saying, seeing all you, he said, boy, boy, boy. It's something else, ain't it? But amen. I just thank God for the life and the legacy that he lived and that he showed me through his life how to live as a man.
Wall.
these have to do with life and death. We are born into life. After our birth, the body of ours go through some changes. And because of the changes that the body goes through, it calls for healing. And so we seek after healing. Because we know that there is a bond in union. It is good for the healing of the nation. Nobody want to be sick, because sickness leads to death. So we look for healing. Healing maintains life. Scripture teaches us that there is a time to be born. There's a time to die. So my brothers and my sisters who sit here with me today at this final service of Deacon Parker, it behooves us to make preparation for eternity. I believe that Deacon Parker made that decision a long time ago. I tell that by words that he will say when he prayed to the Lord at New York World, that he had his business a long time ago, because he realized that this earthly house, this tabernacle, will one day dissolve. But he made preparation for another day that is not made by hand. Brothers and sisters, we all are going to pass this way someday. Make up your mind. I don't know when, I don't know where, but one day your name and my name is going to be called. I don't know about you, but I want to be ready when he calls my name. So sleep on, Mr. Barker. You fought a good fight. You kept the faith. Enjoy your stay in glory. Jesus prepared a place for you, and he came on Wednesday to confirm that this old building that you're living in now is keep on living. But he got a better building for you that was not made by him. Keep on resting in the Lord. Jesus said, I went to prepare a place for you. Where I am, there's no sickness there. Where I am, there's no coronavirus there. Where I am, there's nothing but peace and happiness. Deacon Parker stepped out of time, and he stepped into eternity. Be absent from the body. For a child of God is to be present with the Lord. Therefore, we always have confidence to know as long as we are at home in this body, we are away from the Lord. For we live by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say. And we'll prefer to be away from the body, to be at home with the Lord. Jesus said, I'm going now to prepare a place for you. For where I am there, ye may be also in my Father's house. Many men. So the Lord came and took Deacon Parker back home with him. And we said to him, rest on. He said to this family, weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the morning. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. One of these days, he will wipe the tears from your eyes. Hold on, walk by faith, and not by sight. God bless you. God keep you. Here's my prayer.
Jehovah, pilgrim through this very land. I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand. Bread of heaven, bread of heaven. Feed me till I want no more. The family of Deacon Jerry Parker is most appreciative for all the many kind and loving actions shown to them during their time of need. They ask for your continued prayers in the days to come. The following floor arrangements have been sent. May your precious memories and the sympathy of love of friends help to comfort you at this time. Jerry, I truly miss you. You were like a brother to me. Rest on. Your sister, Ida Ruth Bryant, Shaquilla, Scott, and Tank. The New Oak Grove Baptist Church, W.W. Wixom, officers and members, extend our deepest sympathy to the family, Deacon Parker, Sr. Whereas Deacon Jerry, Sr. was a dedicated and active member of church, he supported his church in every function. His attendance was always known by singing the National Baptist hymns and his humorous saying, I'm still on this side. Be it resolved that the sympathy of this, his membership is extended to the family of Deacon Jerry Parker, that you weep not as those who have no hope, but that you commend yourself to him who is ever present, who both giveth and taketh away. Yours submitted, June 7, 2020, yours in Christ, New Oak Grove Baptist Church, Reverend W.W. Wilson Parker. In loving memory of Deacon Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO, President, and the J.W. Williams Funeral Home staff, present to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. For scripture tell us that weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the morning. The J.W. Williams Funeral Home family present this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our hope that you will be forever remember the many shared memories you share as family together. Finally, the J.W. Williams Funeral Home family present this family with a memorial blanket. It is our prayer that you will wrap yourself in the love and warmth that this blanket holds. And it is our prayer that you will be blessed now and forevermore.
to accept your will. Help them to walk self-respectfully in this world. We thank you for the life and the legacy of Deacon Barry Park. Thank you for all that he has contributed, those that he met, and those who learned to appreciate him, appreciate his life and his giving. Give strength where there's weakness. Hold up, bow down hills. Do this for us, Lord, and we'll be ever so grateful. Give your name the glory, the praise, and the honor. We pray it all in Jesus' name. With each of us until we meet God. And the people of God again say, amen.